My name is Theo van den Broeke, and I'm the Style and Grooming Director of British GQ. I'm here in East London today to present our Peroni Breakthrough Designer of the Year Award to Daniel Fletcher. Fletcher has, in the past half decade or so, made a name for himself as one of the most exciting talents on London's burgeoning menswear scene. With his unique aesthetic and host of famous devotees, including Harry Styles, Sam Smith, and Troye Sivan, to name a few, Fletcher, who is also the Artistic Director of Menswear at Fiorucci, is a more than worthy winner of this year's award. I'm about to head to Fletcher's Hackney studio to give him his award and to learn a little bit more about why his is the name you should be watching right now.
Hey Theo, welcome to the studio.
Daniel Fletcher, congratulations on your Breakthrough Designer of the Year at the GQ Men of the Year Awards.
Thank you so much. This is a huge honour.
What?
It's heavy. I can't believe it, you know. This is really like a huge moment for me. I remember being an intern at Vuitton and seeing Kim come back with his for Designer of the Year.
He's got like 15
now. Yeah, it's good haul. but to be sitting here with one in front of me now myself is huge, huge honour. So thank you all so much.
It's very well deserved. So it's been a massive year for you for a number of reasons, one of the main ones being your appearance in Netflix's Next in Fashion. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I mean, it was crazy. I never imagined doing a reality TV show, but I'm so glad that I did. It was such a wonderful experience. I met some great people, and I never imagined, as a fashion designer, walking down the street and people asking for a photo. It completely changed, I think, like who my customer was, or like it just made the brand so much more well-known, actually.
In terms of sustainability, because obviously, you know, well not obviously, a lot of your collection has been produced out of dead stock, and I think a lot of designers have had to pivot to that because they haven't been able to get the fabrics
If we try and take a positive from 2020, people are thinking more about now what they are producing and the way that they're producing it, because we've not been able to travel to Italy and Spain and Portugal and China to produce things. I've always done all of my manufacturing in the UK, and I'm constantly trying to think of new ways that I can make the brand more sustainable. I mean, for Spring Summer 21, we're literally making things out of offcuts and scraps to kind of make use of those. And the result is that they're not going to be available in quantities of hundreds and thousands. They're going to be maybe like limited editions of like 5 or 10, because that's what's available. And I think that is important to me.
Kind of rewinding right back to the beginning, one of the most formative points in your career was dressing Harry Styles. In fact, he was your first client?
He was my first customer. He bought all the shirts from my graduate collection. I did a couple of custom ones for him as well, and that was a really great starting point for my career. Like, if it hadn't been for him, then maybe I wouldn't be sat here today, actually. So I really owe a lot to Mr. Styles.
I'm sure you would be. That's very humble.
Thank you.
So obviously we don't have a physical GQ Men of the Year celebration this year, but we are doing it digitally, of which you are obviously a big part. And I was wondering if you would consider dressing me for the occasion in some DWF black tie gear.
Of course. Let's get you in some stuff.
Do it. This is a gorgeous coat. Amazing.
Finishing touch. Well, we need this product placement.
Don't do it. Gosh. Thank you, Daniel.
Well, no, thank you. And thanks to GQ and Peroni for this. It's a huge honour.